Okay. How do you dress for success in the world of Zoom and video conferencing? Okay, this is my typical dress for success in the world of pre-Zooming. And, you know, I'd put on my armor, I'd put on my blue suit, I got about 25 of them, my white shirts, I got about 25 of those, and my blue and my red ties, I got about 25 of those. And I wore the same thing every day. I'd put on my armor, I'd go to battle for my clients, and, you know, I'd feel good and comfortable and ready to go to war. Now, I do everything from the home office. And the question is, how to attire yourself? Now, for gentlemen, I've been kind of doing an informal poll, and it seems that the consensus is kind of drawing around a proper shirt, a jacket, and no tie. That's the way it seems to be, that's the consensus that's building for gentlemen on the conference call. The bedhead and pajamas for gents, not exactly the right look. Doesn't telegraph you're taking the call too seriously. And the very informal look makes it look like maybe it's a vacation day and not exactly a work day. Women, clothing is being, you know, more challenging, as it can be. Men sometimes are lucky because they've had an easier uniform to deal with over the generations. But what seems to be developing there, and I want your opinions, this is just what I'm seeing on these calls, is that a plain white shirt, what would be viewed sort of as a t-shirt with a jacket, so very similar to what's developing for men, gives sort of a business feel, but not something that's so formal that it comes across as that you're actually in the office. So those are the two kind of clothing things that are developing in the Zoom world. The next thing is, what do you do for a background? You know, I've had my daughter's, toys behind me and her little tricycle that she goes around on, and you can have the baby crib, and or should you try and make something more formal than I'm doing here with your books, and you know, make you look very learned and serious, or put all your degrees behind you to sort of give you a gravitas in your home office? I mean, what stage should you set? This is, you're projecting yourself. And, you know, how do you think you should be projecting yourself from your home office? Because frankly, we could be here a while. So I'd like to know how you're seeing it and what you're doing, and how you're adapting to this new world of working from home on the Zoom.